Hi, welcome back. In this video, we'll discuss about Sparkline. Sometimes you may want to analyze and view trends in your tabular data without creating a chart. Sparkline helps to perform this operation. Sparklines are mini charts that fit into a cell because they are compact. Let's do it in Excel. Open an Excel file. In this Excel sheet, we have the number of salespeople along with their sales details for the first half of the year, that is from January to June. Now I want to visualize the information to see the trends for each person over time, and to perform this, I'll generate a line chart first. Let's now move to the sheet chart. The chart looks like this, but here it is not easy to see the trend of an employee over time. It is difficult to pinpoint a particular employee and analyze its trend. Here we have a method to create separate mini charts for each employee in a cell, which is known as Sparkline. Let's move to the sheet data. Like here, if we want to create Sparkline, let's first select the data. So we'll select the data from B2 to G2, that is the second row. And now for Sparkline, we'll go to Insert tab. And here you can see there are three Sparkline options available: line, column, and the third is win or loss. We'll go with the column option. Press column, and now it is asking here we can see two options. First is data range and second is location range. In the data range, you might notice that it shows the data that we have selected, and next, location range refers to where we want our Sparkline to appear. So here we'll write H2 and press OK. Here we have the mini chart for employee Sunil. Now drag it for the rest of the employees. For dragging, we just simply look for this plus sign and drag till the end. Let's put heading as trend. Now, as compared to the line chart in the Sparkline, so in the featured Sparkline, you can easily see the trend of each and every employee. That is, which employee has generated the maximum amount of sales in which month. Let's do some exercise with the existing Sparkline. Can we convert this column Sparkline into line or win and loss? Yes, we can. Place cell pointer on any of the cell of Sparkline and go to Sparkline design tab. Here you can see that. Here we have two other design tabs, line and win loss. Let's select line. And now you can see that Sparkline has been converted into line. And now select win loss, and by choosing this option, the Sparkline has now converted into win loss. But it is showing similar columns for all data points. It is useful if your data points has negative values. Let's reverse it to column. Moving forward, next we'll try to see what are the formatting options available with Sparkline. Place your cell pointer on any of cell of Sparkline and go to design tab of Sparkline. Here we are. Here you have option to highlight high, low, first, last, and negative points. Let's select high and low. You can see high and low points are highlighted in red. We can also change the color for high or low points. For that, all you have to do is simply go to marker color. So here you'll find it and select high point and select green. And now the columns with red color have been converted into green. We can also change the Sparkline color by selecting color of Sparkline color command. Here is the command. From here also, we can choose whichever color we wish to put. If you look at Sparkline columns of different employee, then you would realize that you can't compare it with each other. As you can see that the first row has higher value as compared to others, but height of the bars are similar and has no differentiation. To make it comparable, go to design tab and now click on axis. Here you will find the option same for all Sparkline, for both vertical axis minimum value and vertical axis maximum value. Now you can see the effect. Moving forward, let's now understand how can we remove Sparkline. This is easy. We can remove Sparkline from selected cells or entire group. Let's remove the selected one, that is from H2 to H15. For that, simply go to the design tab and click on drop down of clear button. Here is the clear option and select clear selected sparklines. And now the sparklines have been removed from H2 to H15, which is the selected range. And now let's try and remove sparklines from the entire group. For that, what we need to do is simply select any of the cell. Now we have selected this cell and we'll go to design tab. Now access now clear option, and here we'll simply click on clear selected sparkline groups. And here you can see that by selecting just one cell, we have removed the entire sparkline. By this, we come to an end of the use of sparkline in Excel. In the next video, we'll discuss upon the advanced charting techniques used in Excel. Thank you.